is two in the south. I got millions in the south. I got money in the safe. Break the mold and catch a meal to you. And make these non-believers have to deal.
So here's Brown at the plate. Went deep in the ball game last night.
He's hitting for that pop. Came out of the gates.
The 0-1. Runner on the go. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That one's got a chance. And it's gone. Home run number 10 on the year. And they jump out front. It's 2-0.
Playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run, to the slight opposite field into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
And here's the first baseman, Shane Brown. He's already homered in this one. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not.
That one ripped left field. Way back there. Gone! He flexes his power with that swing. His second home run of the game. It's 7-1.
Elevated fastballs, especially away, are like putting a ball on a tee. Hitters do a lot of cage work. They're comfortable hitting off the tees, and he was comfortable right there hitting that ball opposite field for a home run.
So up now for Chicago, Shane Brown.
Well, he's always a threat. Even if this guy is 0-for-3 for the night with three...
And that one hammered. That's back there. Gone! He made him pay for that one. That's his 50th career homer. And they add a run. It's 3-0.
Like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
So up now for Chicago, Shane Brown. Mole goes 5 feet 9 inches, 190. Fly ball, pretty well struck right field. That's back. And that one is out of here. Home run number 40 on the year. And they're on the scoreboard. It's 5-1.
Good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it.
And welcome back. Second inning set to go. So here's Brown at the plate. Singy, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He's the ultimate professional.
Drilled in the air, right field, way back there, and that is out of here. He flexes his power with that swing, and they cut into the lead. It's 2-1.
No, Boone, clearly some frustration out there on the mound right now. I mean, that ball was so close to going foul. Would have been a long strike, but instead, batter gets rewarded.
We go to the top of the fifth. So up now for Chicago, Shane Brown. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not.
Pretty good.
Yeah, it is, and it's not too bad yet, but the field's not going to be able to hold up if the rain gets any worse than this. So.
That one ripped. With one swing, he quiets the crowd. Home run number 50 on the year. And they cut into the deficit. It's 5-4.
Good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
One out, base is empty. So here's Brown at the plate. One for one so far today with a solo homer in his first at bat. He's not. And that one hammered. And it's gone. His second home run of the game, and they add on. It's 4-0. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. Like he's playing wiffle ball up there, and that's typically not the easiest way to hit a home run, to the slight opposite field into the gap. Man, making it look easy, that's for sure.
So here's Brown at the plate, a beast all year long as he leads the league in RBIs here in our final month. That one is absolutely belted. And it finds the basket and gone. So he leaves the yard to left. Home run number 70 on the year. It's 3-0. He sent the first pitch over the wall.
Must have dinner reservations because he wasn't wasting any time at the plate in that at bat. To lose it, maybe it's a habit. I gotta use it. Even if the jazz or the quiet storm, I'll be up. That's an impressive swing of the bat to go over the wall to the opposite field gap. And, you know, there are a lot of guys that just don't have the pop.
And Singy, we have a chance to witness history here today. There's one player everyone's got their eyes on, Shane Brown. He's on the verge of breaking the Major League single season home run record.
And you can feel the buzz in the stadium, Boog. This is a record that transcends the game of baseball. This is national news. His chase for this record has been absolutely remarkable to watch. And the game itself here will actually take a back seat to his quest to set the new mark.
And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. So here's Brown at the plate. Leads the league in batting average with only a handful of games left on the schedule. Closing in on a batting. Come on, big guy. 2-2 now. That one ripped. Back there. And that one's gone into the bleachers. He flexes his power with that swing, his 73rd home run of the season. It's 2-0, and that ties the single season home run record. His next long ball will put him all alone on top of the list.
The excitement's been building for weeks, Boog, and now he's matched one of the most iconic records in professional sports. Every single at bat from here on out is going to be an event as he tries to take the record for himself.
And now the first baseman, Shane Brown.
And you can feel the intensity in the ballpark. Everyone wondering if this will be the at-bat that sees him break the record.
Swing, and this ball is clobbered. No doubt about it. There it goes. Gone. The single season home run record.
What a moment. You know he's feeling it on the inside. This is an achievement that will define his career. Something that's bigger than even the sport itself.
No doubt about it. No matter where he goes from here, he'll always be remembered for this amazing season and this moment. And we've been anticipating this for weeks, but it doesn't make it any less special. A remarkable accomplishment in what has been a remarkable season for him. A moment that will live on in baseball history for a long time.
Absolutely, no question about it. This is something we are very lucky to be able to witness.
And who better to talk about being the MVP than the former AL MVP, Ken Griffey Jr. First off, Ken, how do you feel about this year's MVP pick? What kind of player does it take to win this award?
Well, you know, being named, even if you don't win it, being named in the MVP race is an accomplishment in itself, meaning you had a very good year. Me winning it in 97, you know, it was nerve-wracking because you don't know the voting, how it's going to go. But once you hear your name saying that you won it, it's a relief and you can enjoy it. I had other teammates around me who were there to celebrate it with me. So this year's MVP, you know, he's got some things to buy for the guys.
What was the biggest difference for you heading into the next season?
The biggest difference of me heading into the next year was, you know, the expectations of you got to do it again. So going out there, I pretty much had the same numbers back-to-back years. I didn't win it the second year, but, you know, every year you go out there, you do your job, you go out there and make sure that you give your team the best chance of winning. And, you know, if the numbers come up and you win. But if you don't, you don't. But for the most part, you want to go out there and be consistent throughout the season.